This is the Loom screen capture tutorial for you beginners out there. We're gonna take you through a very, very, very simple seven-step process, very simple steps on how to get your Loom videos up and running so you can make that money.
We are eLearning partners. Welcome to the channel. And this channel is all about simplifying your eLearning so you can focus on the most important part of your eLearning, which are your learners.
Learners, learners, learners. You need help launching your e-learning program successfully. We have a link right below this video. It's gonna help you do that. Check it out. Now we're gonna jump in. So the first thing you gotta do is go to loom.com. Actually, don't do that. Click on our link below this video so you can show us some love, and it's not gonna cost anything additional to do that. It's also very inexpensive. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go get Loom for free.
That is step number one is setting up an account, everybody. And the beautiful thing is with Loom, they make it super, super, super easy, and it is absolutely free.
Exactly. So we're gonna put in our informations, put in a password. So we just created our password. So now it's gonna ask me some questions. What do you plan to use it for? Education, continue. Then we go Jonathan's workplace, continue. Then we're gonna keep moving on through. Who do you collaborate with? Collaborating. And now we go here. And now here's the second thing you're gonna do is you're gonna install the Chrome extension for Loom. Makes it really easy to make videos just by clicking on it here. And you can also download the desktop app. Makes it really easy to make videos as well. So now that we have signed up for Loom, it's super easy to use. We actually prefer to use the desktop version because when you record, you're actually gonna have higher quality. So when you use the extension, the quality is capped at I think like 720 or 1080p. But when you use the desktop app, you can actually get it all the way up to 4K.
Which is awesome.
Exactly. So now, number three, you always want to make sure that you test your recording before you do it for real.
And one of the big things that you want to test is, of course, the audio. Remember, you're doing the screen capture, and what they're going to see is they're going to see either your face or your voice or one or
the other.
They might
see your voice.
But definitely, you want them
Some people can do that.
But as you can see here, the little microphone is going up and down right over here, which basically means that the audio is working. That's always really, really important. I've actually accidentally once did a Loom video and forgot that my microphone was turned off. And after a 10-minute video, I was like, no, I got to redo it. So make sure you don't bother.
You want to make sure it's working. You want to decide if you want your face on screen or not. If you have your face on screen, make sure you're lit.
There we are.
And then we still want to do a test recording. So we'll just go start recording. It's going to give us a countdown. 3, 2, 1. And
action.
Here we go. Hey. Now we're testing, and then we're going to stop, and then we want to play it and make sure that the recording worked. So now we test, we listen to it, we hear our lovely voices, hopefully.
And here we go, man.
Okay, yeah, so that worked. But let's move on to number four, which is record. So now that we're recording, we have some things that we can do. So now we're gonna record. So we click on record. It's gonna give us a countdown, 3, 2, 1. And then we can do some cool things. So we have this menu over here. We can actually pick a drawing tool. You might draw some things.
Which is really cool too. So if, for example, you are, whatever it is that you're presenting, you can underline it, you can make it engaging as you're going through the material, which is awesome. You can change up the colors around. Again, you can underline, you can circle.
Exactly.
You can do so much just to bring that extra little engagement to the screen recording video that you put together.
The other thing you can do when you are using the desktop app is when you click, you're gonna get this cool like yellow pointer. When you just use the extension, you don't get that. So we do recommend using the desktop app over the extension. All right, so now we stop the recording, and guess what immediately happens? It's immediately uploaded to the cloud, so you don't have to take the video upload it to the Dropbox, upload it to Google Drive. Immediately is uploaded to your Loom account, mm-hmm. so you can easily share it with others.
Absolutely, and you can share it on the spot. Once when the video renders, which it will here in just a second, boom, it is done. You can take right here on the upper right-hand corner, there is the little link icon. And if you click on that, you can copy that link and you can send it to anybody. That video is live. It is ready to share to anybody and everybody that you would
like. Exactly. Which is number six. You can share this with anyone. You can also email it to them. It's going to track how many people view it. You're also going to get a notification when they view it, which is really cool. So what you can do is you can actually edit the video as well. So we can trim the clips. So we go to this trim and you can literally just, once it loads, we should be able to pull in the ends of the clip. Yeah, so we can just pull this in, get that beginning and that outro set. We can save the changes. We can actually add clips. So we can add additional clips. So very, very basic editing tools as well. So you can really make a easy, very simple clip. Yeah, you can add other Loom clips. And remember, you can actually upload any video to Loom as well. If you have a clip that you didn't create on Loom, you can actually go and upload that. So those are the seven steps that you can do as a beginner with Loom.
Loom is such an amazing tool. We love this. If you're building online courses, e-learning programs, if you don't have an authoring tool, this is an authoring tool.
It is an authoring tool.
This also acts just like a learning management system. It's a great alternative to a learning management system. There's so many things that Loom has to offer. And not only is it free, but if you decide to go to the paid version, it is super,
super
cheap.
It's only $10 a month or $8 a month if you pay in full for the year. Now, if you're looking for other affordable e-learning and online course solutions, we have a video all about it, the most affordable e-learning solution. So go check that out. We'll see you there.